Interpersonal skills are at the heart of medicine. Interpersonal skills are the skills we use to communicate and interact with others. These include a wide range of skills, such as communication skills, personal skills, and social skills. If you're new to this channel, hi, my name is Dr. Erwin. I help high performers create habits to lead a happy and successful life. I publish new video every Thursday on the subject of happiness and success. If you don't want to miss any future video, don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell. If we look at communication skills, we can divide it into three buckets. The first bucket is verbal communication. This is what you say to the patient. This is about asking questions, whether you're using open-ended question or closed question. The way you signpost your patient about examining them, summarizing and paraphrasing what the patients tell you, and the language you use to communicate with your patient. It's important that you don't use jargon when you're communicating with your patient. For example, if you say to your patient, your HbA1c is very high and you have diabetes. Now, if you avoid using jargon, you may say, the average blood sugar level in the last 3 months is quite high. When you use simple language, the patient is able to understand you clearly. I'd like you to rate your verbal skills out of 5. From 0 to 5, what score will you give yourself? The second bucket is nonverbal communication. There are different types of nonverbal communication, and this include your body movement, how you use your hand gestures, nodding, or if you're shaking your head. It also includes posture, how you stand or sit, whether you have your arms crossed or have an open stance. Eye contact is very important to build rapport. So the amount of eye contact you have with your patient determines the level of trust and trustworthiness. Be careful with eye contact. You don't want to stare at your patient like a psychopath. Next one is paralanguage. This is related to aspects of your voice, such as your pitch, tone, speed at which you're speaking, and how the patient perceives your voice. Personal space is also important in nonverbal. So in some cultures, people like to have enough space between the doctor and the patient to communicate. Otherwise, you can actually make the patient feel overwhelmed. Facial expressions communicate information to your patient consciously and subconsciously. So in terms of facial expression, you could use your smile, frowning, blinking. Smiling to your patient when you're greeting them is something you can use to show your friendliness. Decoding facial expressions of your patient is also an important nonverbal skill to be able to read your patient when you're talking to them to gauge and calibrate your conversation with the patient. If you find that your patient looks puzzled, then you may stop and ask a question to that patient and check whether they understand or you need to go through things again. I'd like you to rate your nonverbal skills from 0 to 5. What score would you give yourself? The third bucket is listening skills. Most people think that they are very good listeners, yet listening skills are overlooked. An analogy I like to use is you've got 2 ears and 1 mouth. Use it in that order. So listening needs to be at least 2/3 of the time you spend in your consultation. In a consultation, it's crucial that you give your undivided attention to your patient. This will help the patient to tell their story and help you to diagnose and manage their problem. Even if you're busy, it's important that you show you're listening to your patient. If you want to improve your listening skills, I've made a video especially for that. Go and watch the video on listening skills. I'm sure you will learn something about how you can improve your listening skills. Now we have covered the three buckets of communication skills. Let's move to emotional intelligence. This is an ability to understand your own and others' emotion and the effect on behavior and attitudes. As a doctor, if you want to improve your personal skills, it's important that you have self-awareness, self-regulation, and motivation. When you have self-awareness, you know your emotions and you're connected to yourself. When you're in consultation with your patient, you'll have an ability to understand and manage their emotion. The doctor-patient relationship makes a big difference. Developing social skills are crucial if you want to maintain rapport with your patient and develop a strong doctor-patient relationship. So this is by showing empathy and sensitivity to your patient. Social skills are about understanding and feeling others and being able to interact with your patient effectively. Let me show you a working example. We have Dr. A and Dr. B. Patient comes in and says, "Doctor, I'm feeling really low." Dr. A has high emotional intelligence and he picks up on the cue that the patient is low in his mood. The speech is quiet and you can see the energy in the voice of the patient. So he acknowledges the patient and says, "Thank you for coming to see me. I appreciate you're going through a tough time." Dr. B has less self-awareness, so he just asks questions and does not show sympathy. So he says to the patient, "What's been going on? Can you notice a difference between the approach of Dr. A and Dr. B?" Dr. A demonstrates empathy and show awareness that the patient is going through a tough time, whereas Dr. B does not pick on the cue that the patient is going through a tough time and just carries on with the consultation, asking questions. You need to explore the information about the patient's agenda, health belief, and preferences. The consultation between the doctor and the patient is a shared partnership. So when you're making decisions, it's essential that you work in partnership with the patient and develop a shared management. As Maya Angelou once said, "I've learned that people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel." Remember, the way you interact and communicate with your patient makes a big difference in their management. The best way to improve your interpersonal skills is to practice. Choose one aspect of communication skills or social or personal skills that you'd like to improve today and practice that skill. I'd love to hear what videos that will be helpful to you. So please share your thoughts, comment, and suggestion down below. Let me know what's your takeaway from this video. Write down in the comment section what's your takeaway. Thank you for watching this video till the end. If you've not already subscribed to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified for future videos. I hope you find this video useful. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.